And he said, look, you don't have to be here. Right? You don't have to be here. وَإِنِّي قَدْ أَذِنْتُ لَكُمْ فَانْطَلِقُوا فِي حِلْ فَلَيْسَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِنِي ذِمَامٍ. You guys can just go. You don't even have to be here because they're after me. وَإِنِّي لَأَظُنُّ يَوْمَنَا مِنْ هَؤُلَاءِ الْأَعْدَاءِ غَدًا. And I know that our day with the enemy will be tomorrow. Right? I feel it's come to an end. The day will be with the enemy will be tomorrow. And you guys are happy to go. I will have nothing against you if you just left because you're after me. And he said, هَذَا اللَّيْلِ قَدْ غَشِيَكُمْ فَاتَّخِذُوهُ جَمَلًا. This night has now come upon us, make it beautiful. This is what he said. This night has come upon us, make it beautiful. Make it a beautiful night for yourselves. Increase in your istighfar and your dhikr and your Quran and your tasbih and your doing good and your good things, your worship. Make this a beautiful night for yourselves. He's preparing them for the events of tomorrow. The strength of Iman, the strength of belief that we're fighting for the correct cause against the people who are out to do damage to this deen. This is why we're fighting. And so he's telling them, be like this. وَلْيَأْخُذْ كُلُّ رَجُلٍ مِّنْكُمْ بِيَدِ رَجُلٍ مِّنْ أَهْلِ بَيْتِي. And let each one of you take the hand of another person, showing them affinity, brotherhood, the bond, the strength, fighting in the ranks, being with that spirit of Islam and Muslimin and brotherhood. Be like that, right? And then he says again, look, you're happy to go. I'm happy. You guys can just go. You don't have to be here. And they said to him, why are you saying that to us? لِمَا نَفْعَلْ بَعْدَكْ. What should we do after you? Right? What should we say? People would say to us, right? People would say, تَرَكْتُمْ, you know, you left. We would say to the people, تَرَكْنَا شَيْخَنَا وَسَيِّدَنَا. We left our sheikh and we left our leader and we left our cousins and the best of our cousins. You know, may Allah never let us see that day. نَفْدِيكْ بِأَنفُسِنَا وَأَمْوَالِنَا وَأَهْلِينَا. We sacrifice for our, you know, our wealth and our children and this for you, for this correct cause of Islam, right? And they mustered their strength on the day of Ashura, on the day of the 10th of Muharram, in the land of Karb, Karbun wa Bala'un, right? The land that was difficult for them, a trial, a tribulation, Karbun wa Bala'un, Karbala. They faced their enemy, and there's thousands of them. There is a contingent of Umar ibn Sa'ad, the contingent of Shimr ibn Dhil Joshan, the contingent of Sinan ibn Anas al Nakhai, each of them coming with a large force, and Hur ibn Yazid is still there. But he hasn't made his mind up. He's kind of on the fence. He's on the fringes. He doesn't know exactly what to do. But they all come to attack him. And he's preparing themselves and they're brave. Ibn al-Athir says, one of those who were on the other side said, I've not seen a person more bereaved of his women and his children who fought more ferociously and more bravely than Hussein ibn Ali. More bereaved when he knows that one by one, they're taken down. One by one, they're being killed. One by one, this bloodline, one by one, the family of the Prophet ﷺ, the sons Ali Akbar, Ali Asghar, 10 months old, held in his arms when he went to go and fetch water, that is cut off. The supplies are cut off, but he's killed, right? Ali Akbar, who was 20 years old, his hands were cut off, he's killed. Qasim, the son of Hassan ibn Ali, goes to fight the enemy, he's killed. Some of his other sons, Abu Bakr ibn Hussein ibn Ali, Umar ibn Hussein ibn Ali, Abu Bakr, another one, ibn Hassan ibn Ali, who had the names of Abu Bakr, had the names of Ali. These two children, my dear brothers, were at the house of Uthman when the house of Uthman was being besieged, to go and defend Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu an. They knew. They had love for the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa ashabi wa sallam. And they knew about sacrifice and they knew about commitment and making effort for this deen, right? And they're being killed one by one. One by one they're being taken down, and the women of course are in the tents and small children are in the tents, and one by one they're being, and Hussein ibn, the first one to be killed is Muslim ibn Usaj al-Asadi, and Hussein ibn Ali approaches him and says, you know, glad tidings to you, for you are the first one to fall for the family of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You know, and he's encouraging them and he's fighting bravely and ferociously. And at the end, of course, they're all killed. The main people, the men, and Hussein ibn Ali is by himself, but still he fights bravely and he fights ferociously. Until these three specifically, Sinan ibn Anas al-Nakhai and Shimr ibn Dhil Joshan, and of course, led by the governor of Kufa, Ubaidullah ibn Ziyad, who had given the orders in the first place, they killed Hussein ibn Ali, and he had more than 60 wounds on his body.